Now, at a given moment in time and space, we wish to learn everything about our universe. How and when it formed, what it is made of now, and what it was made of in the past. We also want to predict how it will change in the future. All of this is a goal for a human lifetime, or maybe a few. This inspired me to study cosmology. When we look at the sun, its light has taken 8 minutes to reach us since the moment it's emitted. And the farther a light from an object in the sky comes from, the longer it takes. So, when we look at the light from stars, we are looking at the light from our past. That light has traveled for billions of years and is just reaching us now, bringing stories from the past. It's our time machine. If light is our time machine, let's look at light from the sky. What do you see here? This galaxy is made by hundreds of billions of stars, billions of suns. Galaxies are, in fact, extremely large objects. But to me, they are small. Our sun is just a point in a galaxy such as this one. A galaxy really is a huge star family. But I'm looking at galaxies from far away. So to me, they really look like small points. Look at this image now. Many of these points are actually galaxies. To me, because I study the universe at very large scales, they look like small dots. The universe is populated by hundreds of billions of galaxies, lying on a wonderful web. This cosmic web that we can see in this map, built thanks to modern data, is actually the skeleton where galaxies form. Looking at the cosmic web, we look back in time. From our tiny Earth, we can study our universe, its evolution. We can travel through time, reading the past and predicting the future thanks to the laws of physics. Cosmologists have gone pretty far in their ambitious quest. We know that the universe is not static. It's becoming larger and larger. It's expanding. This can already be considered somewhat surprising. But a quarter of a century ago, humanity discovered an even more surprising fact. Not only the universe expands, but it's expanding faster and faster at an accelerated rate. And we don't know why. And this has started to happen only recently. Well, recently on cosmological scales, of course, as the perception of time is different for a cosmologist, since I study the universe's lifetime. The mystery that captures my attention the most is to understand why our universe is expanding at an accelerated rate. To explain the accelerated expansion, cosmologists postulate the existence of a component called dark energy. In fact, dark energy is only a placeholder for our ignorance, as we have no clue about what it is. For example, we don't know if dark energy is a constant or if it changes with time. If its nature remains unknown, we believe that dark energy stretches space, pushing galaxies farther and farther away from each other over time. So with time, our universe changes. And this invisible and diffuse component will be responsible for the accelerated expansion. But there is such uncertainty on its nature that alternative explanations for this acceleration are proposed, such as the modification of the laws of general relativity. The cosmology community is really struggling to understand dark energy. Dedicated to solve the mystery of dark energy, we build space missions, such as the Euclid satellite or the Nancy Grace Roman telescope, or ground telescopes, such as the DESI survey in Arizona or the Vera Rubin Observatory in Chile. These are our eyes to look back in time. We build galaxies, maps of galaxies, to actually understand our universe. Mapping galaxies is really a connection with the past. It tells us that the universe expands and what it is made of. Now, let's go back to this image with hundreds of galaxies. I bet that you're all looking at the shiny spots. But I look elsewhere. My attention is driven by the less luminous patches, the spaces between galaxies. In the infinitely large, I am looking for regions with fewer points, fewer galaxies. All these dark spaces catch my eye, more than if they were shining. Because sometimes, too much information is too little information. Sometimes, to learn more, we need to look away from places where too much happens, away from places that gather all the attention. And that, of course, is challenging. So, at the time where everyone was looking at the shiny regions, my collaborators and I decided to address the problem differently, with creativity. If we don't understand dark energy, perhaps we're not looking in the right place. When nothing works, we need to change our perspective. What if instead of looking at those shiny regions full of galaxies, what if instead we looked at the emptier regions, gigantic holes in the cosmic web? The regions where nothing happens, where only few galaxies wander. Those regions, the largest regions in the universe, are called cosmic voids. Looking at cosmic voids really is an absurd idea. There are very few galaxies there. Measurements are hard. How can we get more information? It is, nevertheless, a very good idea. It turns out that the widely accepted model for cosmology tells us that the universe is made at 5% of ordinary matter that we understand, at 26% of dark matter, the matter that we know is there, but it can only be detected through its gravitational interaction, and at 69% of dark energy. So dark energy, this mysterious component responsible for the expansion and the accelerated expansion of the universe, constitutes most of our universe. And we still have no clue about what it is. But we know that dark matter, not dark energy, constitutes the skeleton for galaxies. So if we want to understand dark energy, we need to look away from dark matter, away from galaxies, away from the shiny areas of our universe. We need to focus our attention where no one is looking, to be brave and explore cosmic voids. But why? Because we said that in voids, there is very little matter. So in voids, dark energy rules. Voids are dominated by dark energy. It makes sense to study voids to understand dark energy, or to understand if we need to modify the laws of general relativity. But how do I actually use cosmic voids to study dark energy? My work shows that the number of voids depends on dark energy. Depending on when in time dark energy starts to accelerate the expansion of the universe, we will have more or fewer voids of different sizes. Since dark energy stretches space, remember, it will make voids emptier, darker, larger. So by counting voids and measuring their sizes, I can tell when the effect of dark energy kicks in. I can tell if dark energy changes with time. Also, the composition and the shape of voids itself is linked to how voids are observed in modern surveys. Therefore, I will take maps of the cosmic web, and I will find the gaps. I will map the voids. I will count them, and I will study their shapes, their evolution. And what's exciting is that it's a field of research that can really only blossom now. Because a few years ago, we didn't have the tools. Only now, telescopes are sensitive and powerful enough to allow us to explore large volumes of the sky and to get enough voids, and to probe their faint interior in detail. It's a timely idea. Voids are a true gold mine of information that everyone was neglecting. They tell us more about our universe than any other region. And with voids, we go beyond traditional methodologies for analyzing the galaxy distribution, and we get novel information, otherwise hard to get. Because looking for emptiness is not looking for nothing. It is looking where we should look. Now, the road was not without humps. Many times, the world told us that we were crazy. When giving talks on the idea of using voids to learn more about dark energy, other researchers were coming to see us, wanting to bet that it will never work. The skepticism on the topic was huge. But my collaborators and I persisted, believing it will work. To do so, I had to convince researchers, the few researchers interested in the topic, to work together for a common goal. And together, we won against skepticism. A few years ago, we were only a few. Today, we're more than 100 researchers all over the world. A new research area has seen the light. So, what did we learn so far with voids? We discovered more than 6,000 voids. With this, we can measure exactly how much dark energy there is in our universe, to the percent level, independently from other probes. Voids are already providing constraints that are tighter than ever, and it's really just the beginning. Numbers will grow. A few years from now, we will find hundreds of thousands of new voids. These dark energy-dominated pockets open the door to unveil the mystery of dark energy, its time evolution. They will finally enlighten its nature. It's a crucial, exciting step to new discoveries in the years to come. Humanity is probing the universe back in time, even farther, to measure the position of new galaxies. And I find voids in such beautiful data. Studying cosmic voids really fascinates me. It's a reminder that sometimes the best ideas come away from the crowd, away from the flood of information, in the quietest and darkest spots in the universe. By looking and thinking about places no one paid attention to before, we find a key to unlocking our universe's mysteries and destiny. Thank you very much.